sky. If you see me follow a star, don't wonder why. Don't just make a wish. Trust me, it will come true, because I did it and I found you.
that spacious awareness that lies behind the form. The nirvana that is the other side of the balance of the samsara. Whichever way you want to present this. Is determined by your karmic predilections. For example, some people are very quiet and reflective. And for them, the path may well be the path,
say, of meditation.
Like a Theravada meditation. I've done that for maybe 20 years. And it seems
bizarre when my rational intellectual mind examines what I do
in that meditation.
That I spend hours and, in fact,
sometimes months just sitting, following the rising and falling of the muscles in my abdomen
that goes with each breath.
And bringing my mind down to one point, like a laser beam, and letting go of its identification with other thought, bringing it always back to the center, just like a flower where you go out into the petal and come back to the center, out into the petal, come back to the center, out into thought, out into sensation, come back to the center. Gets really concentrated, it penetrates, and you penetrate into the realm where you are not separate from anything. That is a strategy. The end point of that is not to leave you being a meditator, but to be free.
Free.
And it's important that you recognize, even as you embrace a technique, that every technique is a trap. Every single one. But the tricky thing about meditative practices is you have to be trapped by them for them to work. And when bhakti yoga gets really working, you are so intimate with the beloved that you are at the edge of where the foreplay ends and the merging occurs.
Thank you.
can feel things happening inside of me.
you'll find the truth.
Thank you.